each and every day. Boxes always pay, 'cause I'll take you to where the sun shines, loading you along with my crew. We'll head into space and ship any place that's cargo. Packed up nice and tight, commerce feels so right, transporting you to where the stars shine, moving you the way that I do. We'll always see it through, our credit will accrue, my cargo and I will find you.
Hello, everybody. It is Sunday again. We're here. Are we? Yeah, we're here. Oink.
Yeah, kind of.
And it's now episode number 445 of the Star Citizen Roundtable.
Relum?
Yes?
Fix your video.
What do you mean?
We can't see it.
Oh no, you can't see it. That's
we need real time seeing of you. Not we can't watch the stream.
Yo, Shady.
Who the hell? Oh,
Shady. We love you, Shady. We do.
Oh, you can't trust him. He's shady.
Sounds trusty.
How's everyone doing this fine Sunday?
There we go, that's better. Okay.
Not too bad.
We all ready to start the new week?
I think so. The following week she'll be crazy, I think.
Why?
Well, we're getting ready for IAE and we must get everything right.
No.
Or we can go live.
Nah, it won't be any crazier.
That's the only
hey, Marty.
That doesn't start until...
It's 2 weeks.
Yeah. Ah, we've got time.
2 weeks. Quick, where's the meme? 2 week meme.
They're going to be dropping freaking patches galore.
The 2 week meme?
If anything, we'll get to see maybe...
I mean,
the
this one?
Crusader Intrepid.
No. Oh. Good lord. You knew your memes.
When IAE is coming. No, Polaris. Oh, Idris.
No, we're getting Polaris. We're not getting Idris.
We're getting Idris.
Not that I know of.
No, I don't think we're getting Idris.
Well, we'll get Idris's from the event when they drop the event.
Yeah.
So there'll be that. But you never know. CIG might decide to just give all the Idris owners their Idris's if the Polaris is to
funny.
Be...
You're a funny guy. Yeah, right.
They're not going to wait 2 years to give us the addresses. I can guarantee it.
Oh, absolutely they can.
Now. No. They've already spoiled the surprise.
Right? No.
They've already spoiled the surprise of the address. Because
the one that we're getting eventually is different than the one we see in the PU.
Jeez.
It's Squadron 42.
And we saw a glimpse of Squadron. It's a different model.
Uh-huh.
They told us that they're going to give us a completely different model.
Then they just need to give it to us. Because if it's not giving away a surprise, which is why they told us they're not giving it to us, and they've already let us freaking see the interiors with the Xeno threat and now the new...
No, but as I said, it's different. It's all different.
Oh, who gives a fuck? They just need to give them to us.
We need
something for the Polaris to fight other than other Polaris's.
I spent a lot of money on it. Give me, it's mine.
I just need to throw it out there, let the fucking whole Star Wars galaxy, and not Star Wars galaxy, Star Citizen galaxy, just go to hell in a handbasket.
No, just let the Polaris owners all smash into each other. That's the fun bit. I want to see that first before the Idris.
No, we need to take away their copium and their hopium and all that stuff and just like totally like smash their dreams by introducing the Idrises right after they drop the Polaris. You know,
the Idris is bad because the pilots can't do anything. Same with the Polaris pilots can't do anything except go forward and back and sideways.
Oh, wow.
They can't fire any weapons.
That's what you need a crew for.
So,
crew. You're funny.
True.
As if people play this what as a multiplayer. This? You must be kidding.
They need to crush everybody.
What is this, a multiplayer game?
They need to soul crush everybody. Understand, if you don't have a large organization or group of friends, you don't fly big ships.
Don't tell
it's
me
the
what
same
to
thing
do.
With the space station, really. It's just. Do you want to do this ship by ship then, maybe? Because, you know, you get dropped in a lot of ship in the PTU.
Oh, okay.
Fire missiles. Yeah, okay, that's true.
So, first of all, live
I'm quite surprised
update,
with this, actually.
Without Wait. Downtime?
Oh, yeah. It's happened before.
Yeah, I know. It's just FYI.
It's nice. It's nice when this happens.
And actually, the live branch is now a lot better, I think, right? Last week we were whining about the fact it was just utterly dubious. And
yeah, they kept putting out patches freaking almost every day to try and get the damn thing stable.
Yeah, but there were so many little bugs that was going on. It was just crazy.
Mm-hmm.
They had to, because nobody was playing it anymore. If you were playing it, you were taking so many risks.
That's probably why they made the PTU open to everybody as well. It's like, look, get on the PTU if you don't want to get on live. At least you're helping us test it and get all the bugs fixed in.
So, yeah, I welcomed the A patch. It restored my inventory because I lost a lot of paints just simply moving a box onto the freight elevator, and then I got a server error and I never recovered. So, at least all my stuff was returned.
Yeah, I told you. You were all whiny for nothing.
No, it wasn't all whiny for nothing. Don't tell me what to do.
I didn't welcome the Apex. It broke all my mining actives.
Ah, yeah. Well, there's always a downside. And I'm also surprised by this. I wonder why, but I'm kind of glad they are, because right now, the PTU is, well, very laggy. Very laggy. I wonder why. And it's broken all the PTU records of people trying to get onto it.
Oh. How?
Which way? Yeah, so it's...
Well, that was mainly because people didn't freaking read and understand what was said. And everybody went and started copying their accounts. Deleting and copying their accounts and fucking just killed the server. The only people that needed to copy their accounts were the people that owned or bought the Star Lancer.
Yeah.
So that way they could access it in game.
If you own both ships, you had to copy your account.
No, because it's already credited to your account, the Polaris, from months ago. So you probably already had access to it. It was the Star Lancer that if you needed because they just sold it, a couple of weeks ago? Most people haven't copied over their PTU character because they've just been playing it and playing it, right? I haven't copied my character over in months because I didn't have to. But I needed to get access to the Freelancer, the Star Lancer, I mean. So, I would have to copy my account over. But everybody just started copying their accounts over regardless. Because I didn't. I just went straight in. And there is Mr. Polaris.
Special.
Plain as day.
Special, special. Sorry.
All ways, PTU. Missing focus. Yeah. IAE Halls, Starlin's and Max, Polaris. New global events, Stanton, Safe Stanton phases 1-5. Running Saturday, Sunday, as of right now. Oh, issues.
But anyway,
and then the other issue for lag right now is that they have way too many Polarises out in the fucking universe.
Why?
PDCs.
Why is there way too many? There's no such thing as too many. There isn't, except
from a system perspective and resources. It gets a little laggy.
If there's that many Polarises, then there is that many Polarises. And it's for CIG to deal with it.
They're going to have to.
There's a shit ton.
I'm really glad that this has happened, because this will hopefully make IEE a little bit better. Because imagine they didn't,
absolutely.
Do this before.
No way they wouldn't do that anyway.
I don't know. This is an exceptional year, I think, anyway. Oh, God, this server is lucky as well.
Oh, don't forget, it's like the Polaris technically isn't coming out on the first day anyway. You won't see the Polaris until day 5. Because RSI is like day 5, right?
Yeah.
So you won't actually see it until the 25th or the 26th, Monday or Tuesday.
Well, I don't mind that anyway. Because we'll be busy with the Intrepid anyway, because that's on day 1. How many are you going to buy?
Oh, the Crusader.
I'm going to buy one for each finger.
Why?
I'm joking.
Yeah, that's funny.
We'll be distracted for that, and then... What's the next day? Is it Aegis?
Nobody grabbed the... Hang on.
Is Aegis the Hornets, or is that Anvil?
Yeah. Every hall runs for 2 days, so you shouldn't say it's the 5th day. It's the 10th day.
Well, we won't get it until the 5th day, at least. So.
We won't get it till Tuesday the 26th for the Polaris.
Polaris is RSI, so it's November 26th, yeah.
Actually,
they do every day.
Or is Anvil the Hornets? I forget.
Anvil's the Hornets, so...
Oh, so Hornets don't come in until November 30th. Motherfucker. All the way at the end.
But on the 3rd or 24th, we have Mirai, which is the Guardian.
Are we sure we're getting the Guardian?
We're sure we're getting something, because it's a big gap in the missed call, right in the middle. So I'm sure that's big enough for the Guardian.
No, if it's the freaking Star Lancers.
No.
Oh, the Star Lancers are already there.
Oh, actually, that's a good question. That's a good thing, actually, isn't it? Yeah, you're right. You just killed my dream.
Young coffee.
All right. So then that means there is a hidden hologram as well. So there'll be
that
something
might be
new.
The Guardian.
I thought the Guardian was done, though.
Maybe they decided, you know, it's like, this is what you get for ruining our reveals and stuff like that, and doing these leaks. We're going to push it out even further.
We're going to delay it. You're not going to see it until Invictus next year.
Fuckers.
So there still is the Fortune to come out. So it's possibly the Fortune, maybe the hologram. Though there's a question about
that would
name. Somebody brought up a good point that it's too similar to a Prospector, that it could be an actual Prospector variant rather than...
It looks bigger, though.
It seems longer, just slightly longer, but the proportions seem to be all right. That's the steps in for the Intrepid, yes.
I just don't see how they can turn that prospector. I mean, no, I know how they can turn a prospector into a salvage ship. It's just that, I don't know. It's supposed to have so much more cargo capacity in regards to, you know, having the material maker and all that other stuff that I just don't see how it can be the same size.
We'll see. We'll see. We're only watched one of the bit weeks away now, so we don't have to wait long. The Intrepid. So it's an interesting looking ship. I have to say it's very similar to the Spilett. Same engines. Has the big gun to the side, similar to the Ares. We don't get too many reveals here. We do see two terrapins. I'm not sure if they're actual terrapins or the medivac.
No, one was the regular one and one was the medivac.
That's the Intrepid. Okay.
Yep. If you go back.
Yeah, you had it there. You saw it.
Right. So that's the Intrepid. And then go just a hair further. A little more.
Yeah. A little bit. Careful. Yeah. Here we go.
That's the medivac.
All right. So that's Anvil. So what they would? Oh, okay. That's later on. So Anvil's busy. Boom. You have that, and then you have the two Hornets.
Yep.
Of course, we get the Star Lancer. What else is there?
Polaris.
What's that? Never heard of it.
Basically, everything goes on sale anyway, so.
So, yeah, hope you saved up money. Hope you have your CCUs or upgrades planned. This is usually the time of year when you reorganize your hangar. Everybody, I think, does that now. So, make sure you plan ahead and get what you need, particularly upgrades. I think there's more ships coming out this year than any other IAE. I don't think I've ever remember one having this many.
I'm just disappointed that there's ships that we kind of been hinted at but aren't getting.
Like?
The Apollo, the Fortune.
All right. Well, no.
The Guardian.
Well, yeah, but they told us a while back that they stopped working on the Apollo.
You might as well save it till next year, I guess.
It was on the in the CitizenCon list, so...
Yeah, it was also on the roadmap, yeah.
Oh.
In production, so... And then they pulled it for some reason.
All right.
So, are we excited or are we meh for this year? Is it next week? It is next week.
I mean, the show's... excuse me. 2 weeks. The show is still the same show. You know, it's like... They don't do a whole lot. Mm-hmm. Other than just have, you know, a big hallway with ships all over the place. Which is cool for... It's cool for the people that don't have the ships and they want to try them because they get the free rentals. It's cool for the people that have not invested in the game yet and they get the free fly and they get to enjoy the game, you know? So it's cool from those aspects. If you can afford new ships and there is a ship that you want, it's cool from that perspective. But, I mean... For an old timey like me, I'm just like, eh. It's just another year.
Another year, another empty wallet.
Another year, another empty wallet. Yeah, that kind of shit.
I'm excited because I now have an opportunity to get my hands on a Glaive like finally.
You can. So
you can get your hands on a Glaive just
I have
by...
a buyback token, but
by going in and playing Pirate Swarm. Vandal Swarm.
Well, no, I know that, but I refuse to pay the full price. I don't think it's worth that money. So somebody very nicely got me an upgrade, the basic upgrade. I think it's $10, and so I can now play the CCU game and get it for a fraction of the price. So this is one thing I'm doing is getting a load of CCUs so I can get my hands on that. Because I've always liked that. I pity that they're slightly changing the design of it, but I've always liked that ship. Talking about liking a ship.
Well, if you know that they're changing the design of it, then why get it? If you don't like it.
No, it's an alien ship.
But if you don't like the design, getting changed into.
No, it's me. It doesn't like it when I alt-tab. Hang on. Yeah, Glaive. Oh,
yeah. It's a pity. Now, I will say that it's a pity. That's a nice design. It's a pity that Chris decided to go grungy and
a new version.
Yeah.
Instead of cyberpunk.
Well, I don't know what you call this.
Organic.
Organic. Yeah, that's the word. It is cool in its own right.
Scrappy.
Yeah. Not flashy looking. Mm-hmm. But anyway, it's something I've always wanted. Talking about flashy ships.
All right, I guess we're there. Let's talk about these bad boys. So have any of you guys jumped into a Star Lancer at all? Have you watched one of the gazillion videos people have been dropping on the ships and the can it fit fucking shit?
I've just stood in this corner of the hangar and just looked at it. Didn't do a single thing, just looked at it. That's all I've been doing for the past few days, just standing here.
It's like everybody in Star Citizen is either making a video about can it fit and a tour on this ship and on the freaking...
Well, then give us a tour.
I'll
show you is the biggest whinging of the week, which is, if I can hold that right spot, stop doing that. Is the gap between the bridge, the
dashboard,
and the front of the window.
Yeah, that's MISC.
Which is huge.
You've seen this star.
Yeah, but it's not as big as this. Now, I can understand why they've done this design. Am I moving in your screen or have I froze? Oh.
Is it me? Okay. Is it me? I hope not.
No, it's
that was
me.
Cool.
Wait, hang a second. It's me.
Oh no, crickets.
He went kaput.
And around, Star Citizen, go live. And there we go.
Is he blinking lights?
So, I don't know if you can see it from here. Can we see it? Or is it too dark?
Can't you just clip inside?
You got a tinted windshield.
We'll go inside. Okay. Anyway. It's pretty long, I have to say. It is a long ship. But yeah, it's very cool looking. Not as shiny, and I'm glad, because most MISC ships seem to be too shiny. Come on, let me in.
It's slow loading.
Oh, wow. The door doesn't open now.
Yeah, you got a bad server.
Oh, this is going to be fun. Going up. Are we going to go up? Yeah, here we go. Whee!
Crunch.
At least the inside isn't as loud. Yesterday, the audio was just really, really loud for the interior. But yeah, here we are, and the doors are open. Okay, we'll go forward first, even. Typical MISC ship, you have the escape pods after the bridge. And the bridge is a typical Misk bridge. Two stations, I think these are the remote turrets. Which oddly have a
blast door or blast window.
Yeah. Which says blast door, just to remind you.
Immersion.
Your radar.
Close the blast doors.
Avionics, your mandatory fire hydrogen thingy.
That's in case Jedi with lightsabers want to crash the party. And
what I am surprised is there's no captain's chair. Look at the size of the space and there's no captain's chair.
Yeah, maybe you can maybe you can put in one of those subscriber flare chairs in there instead.
It'd be cool if you could. Actually, that would be excellent. But maybe this huge bloody football-sized pitch here in front of the pilot's seat, maybe they can move everything forward and then fit a captain's chair back
in. It's not a matter of that. It's just, you know, just spaciousness. They want to give you room to stretch out and not feel cramped.
Yeah, it wouldn't be wide enough there.
You know, you got lots of room. If you want to just, like, you know, lay down in the cockpit up there and just watch the stars fly by while you're talking to your you know, buddy, pilot buddy, you know. You just chill out, you know.
I don't really mind it. So this is always the Misk thing. Even the Freelancer has it to some degree, and the Starfarer is even worse in that. And right? Yeah.
Yeah.
Obviously, this is an even bigger ship, so yeah, it's going to have this. I bet you all the other ships in that range is going to do the same thing to the cockpit when it comes to Misk. Like, what's the other one? The upcoming Misk Galaxy? No, what is it?
Oh, the RSI Galaxy?
No, there's another ship, right? A Misk ship?
We have the BLM and the...
No, not the Star Lancer
range. Attack. We don't have any other Misk ships coming up except for the Fortune.
Yes, you do.
No, we don't.
Wasn't there some mining ship?
No, not mining. The salvage.
No.
The salvage. Yeah, possibly the Fortune. But
the Fortune's like a prospector on steroids. The reason you don't have the captain's chairs is because you don't want to be hitting the captain.
But I want to
while you're working on the components.
I want to order people around and point and go, "Oi, go that way."
Oh, that meant the expense, but the expense isn't that big. Well, medium. Yeah, it's a refinery.
There's no button inside here. Okay, so you can lock somebody in here. Interesting. So if we go the other way, more components here. There is a convenient ladder, just in case the lift breaks. And then here we have the mess hall.
And the ladders never break either, no?
No, the ladders never break. Nothing ever breaks. Your table, your kitchen, similar to other Misk ships. I think it's probably taken straight from the hull sea. There's our pool table, yippee.
Where's your pool sticks?
Which is a great thing to see. We use laser pointers. The garden thingy that we saw in Jump Point is not a thing. They pulled that, which is pretty sad. That would have been a nice addition here, add a bit of color, because I think this room is just far too gray looking. It would have been nice to have that.
No, they don't put that in there because they want you to customize your own ship.
It revealed what?
Another fire hydrogen. One thing I've noticed, there's a lot less fuses in this ship. Wait till we get to the Polaris. You'll love that and the amount of fuses in there. Whole load of nothing, basically.
Probably fuses in there. You just don't know where they're at. You haven't come across them yet.
So this is the quarters. He's actually not bad. You have your own personal fridge as well. Don't know what that actually mean game wise, but yeah, it's good at storage. Let's say hit F. we get
it's in it.
650 micro SCUs of storage.
That's in a heavy backpack, I think.
So that's kind of standard. We see that usually everywhere. The bed is surprising. It's a double bed.
Wow.
Yeah.
So it's a quarter two.
Get rocking.
Yeah, you can get rocking. Yeah, absolutely. The thing is, if you pay attention, it is actually two beds. You can see the split in the middle. Okay.
Oh, yeah.
Is the storage up here? No. It should be open sesame. So, bathroom, shower, the poop device thingy with a weird looking toilet roll.
What if you want to poop while you're showering?
Yeah, no,
you can't do that because your toilet paper is going to get all wet.
Well, no, not necessarily. You can take the toilet paper off, but I'm considering that because that's quite an efficient use of your time. And then you just have to bend over use it as a bidet. You can use the shower as a bidet, you know. So I don't know why. For other people, I think this, you are able now to see your reflection. I'm not sure it's on this ship.
Only on the Polaris.
Only the Polaris. All right, okay. We'll get to that then.
Yeah, only they had got the tech. Yeah.
So this is when I discovered I am a vampire.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Same in my character, too.
Open. Exactly the same mirror on the other side. You have this huge elevator here. We'll come back to that in a moment. At the back end, you have similar rooms, except a slightly larger. You have these shelves.
Just shelves? So,
well, you have to put your shit somewhere.
Yep.
But they're exactly the same thereafter. That's the only difference between those two. Open door. What are you closing my face? We'll continue on. And then we have the engineering section. Again, kind of similar to what you see in the hull C. Big components. The usual MISC kind of laser thingy here. Again, you see them in the hull C's. The quantum drive.
Jump drive.
Jump drive and quantum drive. Though that looked more like a power supply, but anyway. Or cooler. Actually, that kind of looks like a cooler. Maybe just using the same assets. Nothing really much here. I think there is a station here. But apart from that, oh, there's your fuses there. One there. Anything on the far side? Yep, of course. But doesn't matter. Fire your hydrogen. Very important. Open. Thank you. So we'll go back to this elevator and we go down to the level below. I don't know why they mirrored. Yeah, there's two of them. One on the other side.
Does this one go outside?
No.
Oh.
You go to the cargo.
I think it's a waste of having this mirror on the other side. It could have been some kind of room. There's no need for two large elevators like this. Oh, it's behind me, isn't it? Yeah. And it brings you straight into the cargo hold, which is kind of handy. I'm not sure if that's good for, say, bringing large components into the engineering section.
That's probably what it's for.
Maybe.
And this is not really necessary. Necessarily a cargo hold because I don't think there's a cargo grid in the center.
Well, not in the center.
It's on the edges. Yeah. That's really meant more for vehicle.
I find that strange. I don't know why they didn't give you the option of both.
Because everybody wants to stick a fucking vehicle in their ships. They don't want to use only cargo.
Fuck the vehicles. I want cargo. Cargo equals money. Pretty convenient window so you can see somebody who you've just spaced. Let's see. Open door. Open sesame. Big ramp, but the height is a bit restrictive. I was kind of disappointed in that.
Most of the important vehicles get in.
Yeah. Can a Nursa get in? Oh, yeah, of course Nursa can get in. Yeah, seen that, yeah. So, yeah, let's go forward again. Open. So, we're in the secondary cargo hold. You have a walkway here in the middle. Cargo goes on the outside, and here is where you open it.
Oh.
You can only put the cargo on the outside because the ramp in the middle is in the way. I don't know. I think they could have designed this slightly better. Maybe some kind of flexible staircase that goes down to the middle, and then you can use the middle section. It seems to me a waste. Anyway. We've seen, I don't know if you've seen it, the Reddit, where somebody actually put those subscriber chairs on the cargo grid, and so it looked like a passenger craft, which is kind of cool. That was a good use of that.
I think I might have that, but...
Going forward, here's the main elevator that goes to the outside, and here is the docking ring. Open.
That passenger aspect of it only works with players. It's not going to work with NPCs.
Oh, no. Well, we don't know. Not yet. Anyway, we don't know what's going to happen with NPCs, but you know what I mean. It's a good use. You can turn it into a passenger ship.
Only if it's players, and you're usually the only ones that are going to do that kind of stuff are the people that are going to try and use it as a drop ship.
Yeah, or role play or something. Who knows? But it's a nice option. At least it works.
And like this?
Fire hydrogen, that's the one. That's the one indeed. Yeah, I think that's pretty cool.
It has a more screen shot, I think. Oh, yeah.
Yeah, yeah. So there, yeah, it looks better in there, yeah. So, you know, it kind of looks like an actual passenger vehicle, so... Why not? I say why not. Going forward again, so we have a suit room, which is kind of cool. You have your weapons locker. Are you gonna open? Why did you disappear to me? Here we go. Looks like it holds 3 rifles. Four rifles, 4 pistols, and looks like 6 multi-tools/mini-guns, etc. You've 1, 2, 3, 4 suit lockers. I can't wait for that mechanic to actually be implemented. It would be really handy if you could do that now. A seat in case you get tired. Immersion.
Mm.
You know, you have to change your socks somehow. Can I get out? Okay.
You're now stuck. Yeah,
and that's basically it. Up the ladder.
Oh, damn, this is frame rate.
Because it's quicker than getting the elevator. I don't care how many says. And, yeah, back to square one. So is it worth it? I don't know.
Yeah.
It's okay. I think the price is good at the moment. I can see them actually bringing up the price. Ugh, lag. Lag. Yeah, I'm really glad they're testing this in the PT at the moment. It takes so long for the gates to open. I wouldn't mind if they had like that kind of music in the background, just the way. My God, the lag. It's really bad.
It's like 5 frames per second.
Yeah, it feels like it. I haven't got the counter up yet. But yeah, it's not bad, actually. But definitely a multi-crew ship. I want to emphasize that. You could probably get away with it single-handed, but you really need a second player at least for this. It's pretty big. It's slightly on the slow side.
Cargo ship, it's not supposed to be fast.
I can see the tactical ship also being equally as slow. But yeah, that is the Star Lancer. Nothing really much to it beyond that. Those are skins. The Sapphire on the bottom right is Poplar. Look, does look nice.
Did they sell those with the ships?
Or
are they going to be sold at the whatchamacallit?
No, they actually sold
them. Own them. Ships.
Okay. Yeah, yeah.
As they would have taken these screenshots.
Set right now.
Yeah. One of them, I think the mauve one is aimed at the tactical version, but it's usable on the Max. So my Polaris is down on the planet. I'm up in the station. So we're going to talk about something else,
down
and then
on
I'll
the
head
planet.
Down. Well, I was rather misfortunate to accidentally press the torpedo gun.
You can get yours to spawn.
While it was in the hangar, and yeah, chaos ensued thereafter. So it took me 1 hour 15 minutes to reclaim it. And it's about 40-something thousand, if you want to speed
up. Well, your Polaris is far inferior to mine.
Why?
Because I fired a torpedo, and I only took structural damage. I just repaired.
Well, actually, what happened with mine is that an explosion occurred which forced the front of the ship up, and it went straight through the door and clipped there and got stuck.
Again, you're inferior Polaris.
I was equally as stuck because I was in the forward section, which was outside, and therefore I was out in the open in the cold. I couldn't get out.
Yep. When I did that, I blew off one of my engines.
Reddit is full of these images anyway.
Yeah, so it's basically what I showed. It's a straightforward ship. No messing, really. I think it could be slightly designed better in certain aspects, but... Yeah, it's nice. All right,
they're definitely putting practicality to a much better use now than they did 10 years ago or something. Which at which point
yeah,
you saw these weird things.
They didn't have the tech. They didn't have. The systems
didn't have an idea
planned out. Yeah. Right. They didn't have the systems planned out and how they were going to work and stuff. And now that they're working, they can build a ship around those systems. So now they obviously have to go back, on some of the older ships and tweak them a little bit to accommodate some of the systems.
Do you know, I think it's like they're avoiding them. They're not going near them at all.
They don't want to.
Yeah.
But they have to. They got to put components in them. It's like it's that thing about, do you invest time and effort into something that's old?
Ew.
That isn't going to introduce any new gameplay or whatever, or bring in new revenue? Or do you invest your time and effort into developing new ships that's going to give you new revenue? That's why I was saying, a few weeks ago, it's like, look, just always put one legacy ship, whether you want to do it or not, if it has all the gameplay features, put a legacy ship into the roadmap. And then just get it done. It's like, rip that Band-Aid off. Just do it.
Do it. Do it
that
now.
That way you're bringing in the older ships. You're satisfying some of the player base.
Wow.
You know, it's like this whole point that I'm talking about. I pointed out the Gladiator. We have all the mechanics. It should be updated and ready to go without having to wait on any new features. Just get the fucker done. They can apply that to a lot of the ships.
Oh, just, super legs.
Just do it. Well, while you go do that and give us another 10th vision of a or tour of a...
Now, nobody's ever done a tour of Polaris before. No.
Yeah, let's talk about other stuff.
There's thousands of videos.
Well, I mentioned those chairs earlier. So these are the ones, subscriber flare chairs. Wow. Well,
you're going to do like a tour, dude, in Marina Commander.
Five.
I think I'm, yeah.
$5? $4?
Four or five, yeah. I do like the RSI one. It's like the one they have on the Phoenix.
But didn't they have it available in the regular store in game? Like at Dumpage Depot?
No,
not the
Are you unique ones?
No. No, they don't have them yet. So this is a handy thing. If you have a load of ships like me and don't know what to take out, just roll the dice and it will let you decide.
Yeah, and I think it'll always choose the same one, though.
It always falls. Yeah, it does. It falls in the same one. Uh-oh. Who did we lose?
Any of us left? Oh, no.
No.
Carry on.
It was your door.
Anvil on board. Yeah, Anvil and RSI.
Since we are talking about flares, let's do a quick segue over to Star Citizen Live.
Oh.
They mentioned that subscriber flares, owners of subscriber flares,
uh-huh,
right? How you have to worry about that whole terminal to get your stuff back and everything, uh-huh, you know?
Yeah.
Well, they're still going to work on that, but
Pause.
Somebody said, I don't remember who it was, and it's recorded, if you own a flare, you will get a blueprint so you can create that flare as a replacement.
That's probably even better than the in-game store idea.
Well, there was a talk about it was a possibility of upgrading your flare using the blueprints to something else. And I think that's probably why they did this.
Yeah. Well, I mean, they still plan on allowing you to go to the kiosk and get your stuff back if you lose it or whatever. Because maybe, it's like, sure, here's a blueprint. Fuck it. I'm not going to use it. I don't care. You know, because I'm not into crafting or whatever.
Yeah.
So I'm just going to go to the kiosk and grab it, you know, that kind of scenario. So they have to do it, you know. But apparently, everybody that has a flare could get a corresponding blueprint when they introduce, well, sometime after they introduce crafting.
Crafting, yeah. Well, it stands a reason, because then you can just make them with the resources you have. You just get the blueprint by standard.
Can I sell them?
If you have the blueprint, yeah, why not? Sure. You can probably make endless copies of it then.
But now, CIG isn't making money because nobody's going to go buy them in-game. I mean, buy them with real money because everybody will just buy them in-game from other players.
Well, that's dependent on how many resources they cost. You know, the fact that they're unique, maybe you need a special crystal. I don't know. They can think of some way to make it.
You need a worm pearl.
Yeah, you need a special.
You need a pearl to do the dye.
You need a special mist, special goo, special.
Special pearl for that top hat.
I don't know. Whatever. You need LTI sweat. You need backer sweat. You need Derek Smart tears.
Derek Smart Tears.
Derek's Tears, yeah. Don't use his surname. Just call it Derek's Tears.
It's hilarious.
I laughed. That was the thing. That would be hilarious. Okay, let's see. Can I get in here? Everything is super laggy at the moment.
Why don't you test this in Arena Commander, dude?
Because I'm in live, so I might as well land the thing.
Because he's difficult.
Live? The Polaris is in live?
Deal with the FPS then.
PTO. Okay.
I was gonna...
So what else do we... What else do we got?
Well,
we're waiting on him. Okay, yeah, there we go. We got our... Did we get it yet? Or is they just... No. Give us pictures.
It's in the PTO.
Oh, is it? Okay.
Yeah. Oh, man, this is so bad.
That's just a trophy. It looks nice. It's
shit.
Okay.
What is shit.
It's going to go boom. You're upside down, mate.
Yeah.
Well, he doesn't play that much. He doesn't know how to fly.
No.
He can't park down, mate.
Oh, come on. Move up. It is accelerating and decelerating beyond my control.
And turn the engines off and let it fall to the ground.
Yeah, that's a great thing.
You have the landing gear down, right?
Yeah. Wow, this is really bad.
This will be a great educational film for how not to do things.
I'll be quiet.
The game's weird anyway. I've had it even when you have that injury, when you can't move your arms, and then you can't fly either. But when you take the drugs, you alleviate the symptoms, so you can temporarily do it. But when you're in the middle of flying and the drugs wear off, it kind of breaks because you can still fly forward and backwards, but not up and down and strafe left or right, which is kind of like, what? This game is weird.
Yeah.
What else did they show us?
The other flare as well. This trophy, that one was also a redacted item from.
I think that's very cool looking. I hope it's big.
Is it just one or is it three?
No, just one.
No, it's just one. It's a Vandal Skull. It's from the CitizenCon goodie pack, one of the redacted items. Yeah, that's cool. Kind of cool. But that proves that the Vandal race also has bones.
They have human skulls for decorations?
Oh, no.
They have bones. It's just they have an internal system where they can breathe in space.
No, they were wearing masks.
Were they?
No, I think that's only decorative, I think.
I don't know the lore, whatever. So yeah, that one you get, and then this one you get as well.
Plushy, Warren plushy.
Yeah, everybody's calling
it. Looks more
it
like a dildo.
They're calling it a fleshlight.
Fleshlight, yeah. For those who want that extra pleasure.
Yeah. It's ribbed on the inside. With the little teeth.
All right, where's the blood?
And we're supposed to get that what? When they drop.
It depends on how big this thing is.
Yeah, it's on the 0.3, so.
Yeah, it will be with that patch. Yeah.
Well, no, they already gave us a 0.3.
Yeah, they're in there.
In the PTU.
So they should be in live then.
Well, actually, I haven't seen the worm or the skull yet, but I have seen.
Oh, no, they gave us. I'm sorry, they gave us a 2A.
The chest, the IAE, not the IAE, the CitizenCon chest is in there as well.
There's
a chest.
It was just one SCU container?
Mm. What am I doing here? Where is it? Container. Is it here? No, it's not there. It's in here somewhere. It's probably in the others. I did see it. So much stuff.
It'd be at the bottom then, no?
It probably is. Hang on a second. Chair. No. Table. There's the CitizenCon trophy. There's a cockpit. Cockpit recorder prop. Black box, basically. Yeah. You're getting a black box. There's the CitizenCon 2954 storage chest. Yeah, I haven't seen the rest yet. Maybe I need to recopy my account again. Anyway, that's... God, the lag is unreal.
Maybe you need a new computer.
I do need a new computer. I am actually looking to get a new card. Hopefully on... What do you call it? Black Monday? Is that the...
Friday.
Black Sunday. Black Friday.
White Monday, Black Friday. Whatever.
It's Cyber Monday.
They usually run the discounts like for 3 weeks around Black Monday and Black Friday anyway. Never just one day.
They actually start to do sales before Black Friday.
Oh yeah, that's what I mean. Like yeah,
because they everybody's fighting the for your week. Money. Everybody's fighting for your money. So do we want to talk about Inside Star Citizen?
That was just a recap of CitizenCon behind the scenes. Well, it was a cool episode, but...
Yeah, cool, but nothing that we really need to talk about. There wasn't anything involving the game itself. So where all the good news and all the fun stuff came from is Star Citizen Live.
Well, in fairness, I actually did enjoy watching the whole setup of it.
Oh, yeah.
The whole rigging. Pretty advanced rigging was used. So, like, they didn't penny pinch there, I think.
Yeah, they spent more money on a show than they spent on development. Okay, great.
Yeah, no, I knew they weren't expecting because there would be people still on their break. But yeah, I enjoyed it. It was, you know.
I mean, it was nice to look at, but there's nothing really to talk about from our perspective other than it was cool to see behind the scenes. You know, a lot of people like that kind of stuff.
Mm.
But what we really care about is Star Citizen Live.
M.A.
Because they had a lot
M.A.
of M.A. good information.
Lights.
Yeah, but there was no visual stuff there in there, right?
Well,
no, they didn't have any screenshots or anything like that.
No, nothing like that. Yeah, all the employees were forced to work, help out
under the crack of whip.
Yes. It would have been nerve-wracking if you think about it. Like, you know, standing in front of thousands of people is not a...
These are devs, not presenters.
Yeah, exactly, yeah. And I think the community forgets about that sometimes. I have to say, Manchester looks well. Those new buildings definitely have spruced it up a bit. Look at the size of that wall. Jesus. That video wall. But I remember seeing rigging like this, like say 30 years ago. It's wow, how simple it is nowadays is unreal. This model is just fantastic. I'll just repeat that.
Jeez.
Just my only ever so slight downside to it was that it wasn't real size. And again, I said this last week, I love the use of the cargo containers. That's a very clever and simple design. Quite effective. Oluf.
Yeah, I saw a bunch of... How many community managers they have nowadays? Like 10?
Yeah, there's a load of them, yeah. We see they're split up, so...
There was another one in here that I never saw before. Was at the beginning or something? No, it was some dude. No, not
him,
Jared.
Yeah, I never seen him before. No.
No. I don't know. If someone makes a list of that anyway.
Um.
Oh my god, so many people. Look. That's Meyer.
Meyer again. I think he said he was every single citizen gun. That's impressive.
Yeah. He was in Frankfurt too when I was there. He was one of them getting scanned. He's getting his face scanned.
Oh, that's right, rig. Yeah.
That they stopped using thereafter.
Yeah, I think that they went to third-party companies after that, which was sensible. Why invest the money yourself when you have another company who will put the extra for better quality equipment? Again, super cool models. That just blew my mind.
Mm-hmm. And then there's a recap of all the shows.
Mm-hmm.
Top head. Yeah. Oh, you already have it. Oh, look.
What? Oh, this? Yeah.
Well, how long does it take you to run to the other side of the hangar?
Well, it is the extra large hangar, which is too big, but
definitely time it.
Yeah. I don't think
with that frame rate, it just takes you a long time.
Oh, funny, yeah. But it's big. It's huge. It's definitely my biggest ship flyable so far. There's no doubt about that. I was kind of overwhelmed by the size of it. And then, of course, then the realization dropped.
RIP servers.
RIP servers, indeed.
They're coming.
Oh.
Hey. Another tour of the Polaris.
Wake me up when you guys are done.
Oh, look.
Okay. Big ship. Look. Missiles.
Missiles.
Guns. Big guns. So, from missile turrets, Parasite 6s. I thought there might have been 7s, but no, they're only 6s only. And you can see the torpedo tubes there.
Mm-hmm.
Size 10s, you have the 8 size 3s on either side of the bridge. And then you have a missile turret at the very back, which holds 12 size 2s. So, yeah, plenty of missiles. Plenty of firepower. You've, I think, 5 man turrets in total, 2 remote, and 9, or was it 7, point of fire. Point defense cannons, which is kind of controversial, maybe because it's only the first iteration of it, but
well, I saw a video of it being in use, some dude on Reddit, was it?
Or no, you they are in use, but one, it's quite restrictive because it only works against missiles or torpedoes. It doesn't work on ships, which is a kind of a pity. But it also depends on what missiles are firing right now, because while the big torpedoes are slow and therefore easier to shoot at, the other missiles aren't, and therefore it doesn't hit it, doesn't stop it, and they just keep hitting the ship.
Well, that hit it. Is this?
That definitely hit it.
That did not.
That's it for. No, because I think the point defense are hitting it. But it's slow enough that they are actually effective. But it's a bit hit and miss at the moment, I think.
Yeah, I can see that.
The server lag isn't helping. I think that's probably the main the main issue. This is what it looks like. It's not interchangeable at the moment. You can't just put any gun there. Very restrictive. And as I said, it only fires at missiles, not at ships. And that means bad news for you solo flyers. Yeah. What happened here? All right. So let's go in. Where was the door? Door was around here somewhere, wasn't it? Where was it? That was up in the front, isn't it?
We really need like remotes.
Well, you have to go up to, I think what you do is you go to that indicator, and usually there you go. There's your F floating in the air. Yeah.
Is that gonna stay like that?
I don't know. And then there's a bit of a delay, and you hope that by pressing F it actually worked.
It takes a while to actually go down, I guess.
Yeah. There we go. Again, the door is not working. The door, yeah. It was working yesterday. And I think the gate is also laggy. Do, 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 do.
Wow.
You gonna let me in? Wait, do I have to press F twice? Oh wow, that didn't work yesterday. Bridge, come on.
Hit it.
We go. We're going in.
Oh, it's open now.
Yeah. We're going up and up and up. Will it ever end?
Main deck.
Just to remind you that you're in the main elevator. Level 1.
Come out.
Hello. Come on. Let me out. There we go. Wow. Okay.
You can't look at this thing in Arena Commando solo?
Everybody keeps saying it, but I'm here. Too late now. And just for confirmation, main lift.
Oh, no, it's no longer elevator.
Elevator on your side, lift on this side. Which I find interesting. Oopsie. All right, so we go to the bridge. Push. So again, like the MISC ships, the escape pods are immediately behind the bridge. I think pretty roomy, and they have the switch here. Can't wait for that gameplay to actually be in place. That should be fun. Anyway,
it's I find it interesting they keep putting the escape pods on the ships, because they never told us how they're gonna work. Greenlancer has beds.
Yeah, the beds make sense because you're already encased in it. So, the freelancers, the roof of the freelancer has no way of the skate pods actually getting out.
Which is another reason why that has to get out of work.
Yeah, exactly. Anyway, so you come straight to the, I don't know what you want to call this, the situation room, the CNC hologram thingy. Monitors everywhere, which just have placeholders, so I'm guessing hopefully practical information will be on here. That'll be nice. I'll probably spend most of my days on this section of the ship. Then you've tons of components all hidden in here. Come on. Not lagging. Oh yeah, this is the Cerberus. My god, there's so many Cerberus. It's a mirror of the far side. And then we have... This is where the huge, gigantic blades will go in. I don't know what goes in here. Look at the size of this.
Big.
You can imprison somebody in there.
Yeah, it's a brick cell.
Trade was complaining about this space. This is a waste of space, apparently. And then we come down to the bridge, which is huge. And other terminals, which I'm guessing is going to be something else. Like they do say tactical and security and... What was it? Science and communications. So hopefully they'll be actual useful. Right now, these two seats are just basically turrets. Though I thought there would be something like comms or navigation, maybe. You do have a captain's chair. Great view, really. Fantastic.
Mm-hmm.
And then your usual pilot and co-pilot. Actually, I'm not sure what the co-pilot does. I think they have access to the missiles. Anyway, I'll go through here. Open! Open! This is almost as bad as the Crusader ships with the amount of doors. Probably even worse.
It's a fire fuses. Safety thing.
No, they're not as worse as the Crusader ships.
Fuses everywhere. Everywhere. I mean, it's not even funny the amount of fuses on this ship. CAG is probably making this ship really difficult for us to maintain. This, I believe, is the captain's quarters, but for some reason, it's locked. So it's quite possible this has not been finished.
What?
Yeah. So I can't get in there.
The Polaris Captain's Quarters?
There's nothing behind it.
Yes, it's in the patch notes.
Is it in the patch
notes? Yes, it's being worked on.
Okay, well, there we go. We're being scammed. We're only getting a partial ship.
Well, that's why it's on the PTU, for us to find the bugs. It's not a scam. Full release yet.
This is disgraceful. All right, let's see. Did I miss a room? I think I missed a room. An important room. This room, yes. So here is armory. Your change room. Armory, quite a lot of like decent racks here.
Well, for big guns.
For big guns and the rest of the guns. Good number. Is that a radiator? I don't know. But yeah, so many cabinets. Quite a lot. Chair for when your feet are sore. And the largest ventilation thing I've ever seen. So yeah, that's for your Marines. Open. Straight across from the main elevator, which now says elevator. That said lift. No, it's elevator. Okay, that's hilarious, right?
I think it was Z fighting with another.
It probably before. Was. Yeah. I guarantee this was this made in the UK? Of course, where they use lift, and then some Yankee came along and said, "No elevator." What's this now? So this is one of the man turrets. Let's pop in.
Oh, they're man turrets.
Yeah. So there's three man turrets, I think, in total. So these are the ones that holds the size 4s on the outside. Are you going to let me out? Oh, wow. Okay. I zoom in here.
Oh, yeah, those.
Yeah. Can I turn this without? No, I can't. Okay. At the moment, they have Omni Sky 12s on it.
These were cannons. The
yeah, I don't know. I don't think that's the best gun for this. They have a slow rate of recharging. You're definitely going to have to arrange your setup a bit better to speed them up. Normally, you'll probably use something like the attritions or the larger size of the attritions, but they are bulked as well. Anyway. Can I get out of this chair? Yeah, you can barely see me go down. Whee! Doop, do 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 do. Come on. Yeah, maybe I should have done this arena commander. Mirror on the other side. Here is the mess hall. And my first major disappointment. There's no pool table. So I'm really angry at that. The concept promised us a pool table. Where is my pool table, Chris? Really angry. But we have this sunken pit here. So you can just sit there and talk to yourself. You have your kitchen here, which arrows indicating the way to queue.
The queue line. Oh, wow.
Squirting machines, where I am guessing your food is dumped up on your tray.
You can just shout soup at it.
Soup, yeah.
And it'll make soup.
I remember in the original concept, these tables were supposed to fold down and chairs into the floor. But obviously that's not going to happen. Oh, look. Fuse. You do have this little TV corner here, so you can watch nothing.
Is it the art logo? No.
Nah, it's some kind of fingerprint, I think. Digital fingerprint. I'm not sure what that is. But I'm not sure why you put this in. Are they going to allow us to watch videos? Yeah.
Well, that's the whole thing with the Mako Reliant. That's still somewhat very unclear. Yeah, it was supposed to be for content creators. It had all these screens where you could, you know, stream shit. The hangers here. I don't know how that works.
The hangers here, but we won't go into this because we're going to go double back here. Open. So this is the corridor that we went into the mess. There's the mess in there. You can see through the windows.
Oh, right, yeah.
And on opposite that entrance, we have the entrance into our accommodation, which is actually, our habitation, it says here, is actually pretty decent.
Ooh, plants.
Fuses. More fuses. Plants, yeah. And so we have these, what I would consider actually not bad, quarters. It is a double bed, but it seems quite comfy. You have a little seat there. And here is your bathroom. Open. Open. Oh, lag. Get in there. Open. So there's your shower poop unit. And then, if I turn around...
Oh my god, it's got no head.
Oh my god. Oh. Can actually see ourselves in the mirror.
But not
so
quite.
As you can see, it's not a mirror. It's a TV screen. Because you can even see the camera on top.
Oh, wow. Okay.
So... Yeah, everyone's saying you can see yourself in the mirror. It's not a mirror. Okay, kind of cool, but yeah, it's a bit weird, especially when you're not. Ooh, wow, you're not seeing exactly the reflection of yourself. Cool beds. There's a little screen up there. Where is this? So your storage now. This I was surprised because this contains 2,000 micro SCU.
2,000.
Yeah, that's quite impressive, actually.
And then another one next to it.
Yep, another one next to it. Exactly the same. They all have. So 4,000 and all. That's actually quite decent. That's TV screen is wonking, yeah. And basically there is, what was it? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 rooms of those. So that's pretty decent. I'm not sure how practical that is in gameplay. But anyway, we're back out here. There's the main entrance to the hangar.
Uh-huh.
Don't go there just yet. So on either side of that main hangar door, we have this. This is the important ladders. Why? Because ladders. Yeah, it's quicker to go down the ladder and up down the ladder than is the elevator. This will bring you down to the cargo hold. We'll go down there later. There's another one down there. As we continue on, we come to this. So we go down these set of stairs, and this will lead us to the docking ring. There are two docking rings, one on either side. Are you going to let me in? So this will be interesting when boarding. So you have to get through that door and then get through this door. Gain access to the ship. It could actually double up as an airlock when the room system kicks in. And I won't go too far. There's your... Is it out? Yeah, here we go.
Yay.
So, as you can see how big the ship actually is. It's a monster. It really is big.
I saw a picture of it next to a reclaimer. It's almost the same size.
Yeah. Now, the reclaimer is bigger in volume. But I think it's slightly longer than the reclaimer. Maybe slightly wider. I'm not sure. Actually, no. I think the reclaimer is wider. But definitely dwarfs the Carrick, and that's a big ship.
Oh, yeah.
So this definitely brings a new level to the game.
Much more packed than the reclaimer anyway. Yeah, it's more stuff in it.
With the reclaimer, I think it's just one gigantic placeholder. Anyway, that needs to be redone. There's so much systems that are not in place. The drone room is not there properly. The stellar cartography is not there properly. The engineering station is not there. You know?
They never should have made that back then because they had no idea what they were doing.
That's what people were calling for the ship anyway. So we're on the starboard side. And again, this is another access to turrets. I think these pop out the side of the ship. Ugh, come on, or does it go down?
Go down. Good.
Going down. Whee!
At least you're not upside down.
Oh, yeah, we do come out the side. Yeah, I was right.
Oh. Yeah, those things, yeah.
Yeah. Zoom in there.
So when they're not in use, they're not ejected. The door's closed.
Door's closed, yeah.
Oh, that's kind of nice.
So I do like that, yeah. I always thought turrets need to be hidden anyway. And it's kind of similar to the hammerhead. You're kind of pushed out from the rest of the ship. It's actually separated. I think there are 4 size 4 panthers on this. Anyway, let's get out of here. As I slowly die of thirst. Yep.
Down the tube.
Going up.
There should be a water slide instead.
Oh, beautiful. Seriously? Okay. This water slide, that'd be funny. Interesting units with a keypad. I'm not sure. I don't know. System analyst console. I.e. a pain in the backside. Oh, look, more fuses. More escape pods. Maintenance.
That's where the broom closet is.
So we have these 2 side hangar doors. We'll go through that in a moment. On the left here, we have, for bold people, the brig. Dun, dun, dun. So in here, you have 2 holding cells. Decent looking, actually.
They're fancier than the quarters?
Well, almost. That was weird fog in here. I don't know. But yeah.
To make it eerie feeling.
Nice bed, exposed toilet and sink. Don't think there's a shower. Same on the other side. And the cool thing is, and I look forward to the player who's actually going to get involved, you have a CCTV camera in each room.
So I can watch people poop.
So you can watch people poop. Our troll poop at the screen.
This camera, yeah.
Yeah.
Can you see the cameras?
Good question, actually. I think I do. Yeah.
Oh, those things, yeah.
Yeah, wow, they look really old. Camera.
Who the hell?
Hey. It couldn't at use
very least
dome,
it could have
no.
made a dome camera. Yeah.
Yeah.
That would have been more fun. Yeah, this is like 90s. Yeah,
no, even older. They were around since the 70s.
Yeah.
That's so anyway, we'll go into the infamous hangar. I think most of the posts are what can fit in here.
Some do are making a list.
It's a lot bigger than what it was. This was only supposed to be originally able to hold
one fighter. Right?
When I was rewriting the wiki there today, I was wondering what to describe this. So I still called it designed to comfortably hold a light fighter. But it's quite clearly you can put much larger in there. And so now we switch to the images that the community has nicely provided for us.
yeah.
Because this is an interesting asset. Well, that's actually pretty good. Somebody actually managed to get the PTV Grey Cat in the bridge. I'm very impressed with that. That's I must try that later on.
There's people ramming into the does it fit?
Well, it's on our Discord channel now.
Yeah, I know. Here's the list, by the way.
All right, okay.
Well, this fits Fred. Comfy fit. Pretty much everything but life-threatening fit Vanguard. Doesn't fit Prowler, Zeus, Shulen, Cutlass, Freelancer, SRV. Gets in, Kind of close to the hangar door. Redeemer, also not. Oh, and a cargo hold. Like, uncomfy yeah, fits, dragonfly.
Well, that's because of the hover.
The hover.
Kind of yeah.
Life-threatening fit Spartan. Doesn't fit the Nova.
So, well, the Spartan's actually interesting because it clearly should be able to. You can clearly see this gap between the top of the Spartan and the door entrance. But for some reason, it's hitting something invisible.
On some invisible geometry. Yeah.
Yeah. So that's the fault of the Spartan. Maybe the I don't know what it is, but yeah, that should fit.
No man.
Somebody is. Yeah. See, so there's a difference here between
to the door and the air shield. Yeah.
Yeah. So the air shield, we can see this white strip going around the edge of it. And there's a small gap between that and the hangar door itself. So you can get away with something going over the air shield, but just under the door. So a few of those ships actually can get away with it. I think the Vulture gets away with it. I know Vega's really happy with that. But yeah, it's very spacious in here. Somebody managed to fit, I think about 18.
These were 12, and these were...
That's 12.
18,
well, I don't know, yeah. It's 18. I don't think there's 18 there, though. What is it? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. There's 15 there.
And then...
There's, yeah, I think they're four. Is that three or four? Three each? That's six.
Yeah, and he has a rover in there as well.
So...
Other stuff, yeah.
So you can use this as a pocket carrier. There's no doubt about that. But what people don't think are realizing just yet is that this really needs to be kept as empty as possible because this is the way of resupplying your ship.
Yeah, the doors here and there and there.
You have two elevators at the ends, which some of the ships are on top of. So there's two on either side. Yeah.
Where does that go?
And they
down?
Bring down to the lower cargo hold.
Oh.
So you can either bring stuff through the cargo hold and bring it up here and then do whatever, or vice versa. But it is large enough to fit the size 10 torpedoes. So you could have a ship bringing them in here and then you drop them down if you wish.
Mm-hmm.
So it's wise not to completely fill this all up. There are these blast shields actually here. I don't know how to operate it. I haven't found the button yet. Unless is that it? Oh, that's the elevator. But there are four blast shields that pop up around here. But yeah, it's big. So we'll go forward here, hit the open button, and then this brings us to, I would consider to be quite weirdly arranged. So there's a lot of wasted space around here, though there are these, I'm guessing, for future components. I don't think this, yeah, we were here. Before I go down to engineering, I forgot to bring you down the other side. On the other side, opposite the brig, a nothing corridor. Yeah. I wonder are they going to be used to trap players? So if you can get players in there and close them behind, can you trap them in there? Empty the air. And,
well, I'm guessing that's the idea behind. See, it sounds annoying to us when they have so many doors that you have to go run through, but they can be used as deterrents to stop assaults from advancing. If you can lock them out, so they'd have to hack the next one and then hack the next one and then hack the next one. It's, it sounds dumb, but it's how you keep them busy, you know?
So this is cool. You have a medical set up here. You have two beds here.
Always with the glass doors.
So you can You know, they might have a disease, you know.
He's tier one.
So I don't know. How do I find out? I heard somebody saying they're tier two, but
that wouldn't make sense. I'm not sure.
Yeah, I thought they didn't prefer to give tier ones only to dedicated medical ships. I think the Apollo
and the hospitals,
tier one in the hospital, so they weren't too keen on giving tier ones to anything else. But I do believe it's the tier two, which is still good enough, especially if you're a marine. And also. Oh, there we go. So walk into the door.
Yeah, that's what I mean.
Yeah, I know, yeah. So.
Loading.
Loading. But I'm guessing there are also going to be cameras. Actually, I must look. Is there cameras in here? Open.
No.
No. Okay.
Maybe there'll be. Instead of cameras, there'll be monitors for checking the patient information in in those two rooms.
But yeah, that's cool. Again, I'm not sure who's going to sit there and actually do that role.
It's going to be the doc on call.
So, moving back again. So, the engineering section is a bit weird. So, firstly, when you come out of the hangar, you go straight into this elevator, which brings you down a level. We'll be back here in a second. But if we have these set of stairs that bring you into the engineering section. So, there's a section at the back. We have this, which somebody said looks like a quantum computer. It does. Looks very much like a quantum computer. Somebody just said this is a giant shredder, shredding machine.
Yeah. Incinerator.
But it says battery component system. So, we have this, I believe, is the drives, I think. Yeah. Which looks like they're too big for here. But if these are capital components, that means you cannot remove them. Isn't that right? So.
Yeah, we can repair them.
Okay. So yeah, that's your quantum and that's your jump drive. There's the gravity ball. Spinning. Don't get too close. Again.
Fuses.
Fire hydrogen. Stations. This is to control the hot and cold tap water system. Joke and curse.
Life support.
Okay. And it brings it down this set of stairs, which has access to the rear elevator. And I'm guessing this is the main terminal for the whole engineering section, which is just weird. I mean, I don't know what to make of this.
Ribbon cable with that light effect.
That's water. It has a water cooling system. And I said this to trade yesterday. Imagine the gravity went out. What would happen? Where would the water go? If you've ever seen the movie shielded. Passengers... Have you ever seen the movie Passengers, where one of the characters was swimming on the spaceship and the gravity went away, and then the whole thing turned into this ball of water that you couldn't get out of? It's scary.
Really, yeah, because scary. you get when something like that happens, you get left to surface tension effects, because that's the only force that still applies, because the Water will attract the water to each other, including you.
That genuinely sends shivers down my spine when I saw that scene.
You'll just drown.
Yeah. Yeah, again, I don't know what CIG were thinking of.
Maybe they probably won't do anything. They'll probably just stay there. Probably. I think they have that water physics.
Really cool. So, probably janky just, elevator.
Maybe it's just air shielded. It won't ever go out.
So, I just want to point this out. We are on engineering deck. And now we need to go to the cargo bay deck to get to the engineering section.
That's nice.
Alrighty.
Okay. So here we are at the cargo bay deck. Ribbon cable. Seriously. There are ladders down here for some reason. I don't know why. There's nothing down here. There's no station. There's no even fuses down there. Maybe just get closer to the water.
So you can watch it explode.
Yeah. Plenty of stations. We have these things which pump up and down.
Oh, that's the Vader effect.
Another station which controls these things. The meat grinders, as I call them.
We've seen that in Squadron 42 as well and other ships, right?
This one, we don't see the effect until the back of it. And so we have these. I do not know what this is. Is this taken to a different dimension? In a weird way, it reminds me of the laser in Tron. That sucked.
The aperture of the
lions, but yeah. So yeah, there's a lot of fluff in here. So this then takes us straight into the cargo section.
The actual cargo bay, yeah.
So this is actually quite decent. It's a bit low ceiling, but yeah, it's good size. It really is. You have a console over here. I'm not sure what that does. This is the ladders that I showed you earlier on.
Mm-hmm.
So again, I recommend using these. It's quicker to use that. This is the elevator that brought us up to the hangar. So if you can get through the hangar, if you're invading a ship, this would probably be a good way of getting in. Jump down here. Just exactly the same on the opposite side.
But this one has a ramp to access, to drive into from the outside or something, I hope.
Yes. So,
but you can't take vehicles to the upper bay then.
So apart from the Idris, which we know, whoops, this actually drops. I don't like that. The ramp is huge.
Oh, damn.
It's really long.
Well, it's got to be, because since this ship's quite high above the ground, I guess.
So
it can't be too tight of an angle.
Don't use a hover bike coming up here just yet. It's dangerous. I don't know. CRG haven't got that really worked out properly. But for ground vehicles, it's fine.
You really need to get the bikes with the wheels.
Yeah, I think
done.
You do.
The Rangers.
They just can't seem to get the hover tech right yet. It has an air shield, so that's good. I'm not sure if you can open this without opening the ramp. This would be nice for space, especially for those Fury ships. This could be some kind of launch position. I hope you can open this without extending the ramp in space. But it also would be handy for alien worlds as well. Alien atmospheres kind of thing. But don't pack this too much with ships, because you can also pack this with torpedoes. And I'm saying this because right beside it here is the torpedo rooms.
It's a loading elevator?
Yes. It's a loading elevator. I won't go in it because the collision is a bit wonky. But let's see. Yeah, there we go.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. And so if you can fill this full of torpedoes and then bring it up here, fire hydrogen. And this is your turret. What's it called again? Rotary feeder system. That's the official term of it in the real world. Each feeder contains 7 torpedoes, all size 10s. Pretty powerful indeed.
Sweet.
Yeah.
And there's and this like 4 of them?
So it just there's 4 of them. There's 28 in total. Plus your cargo hold means that you can carry quite a lot of torpedoes. So please take that in mind. And don't fill it with fighters. Use the hangar for your fighters and keep this for everything else, particularly torpedoes. Now, I'm not sure what it's like reloading these. We haven't seen that yet. I don't think we can even buy these in-game.
There's another reason to redo the Freelancer, since the Miss variant was supposed to have that interior loading system.
Yeah. Yeah,
you kind of saw it because it's visually there. You can kind of see it, but the missiles just come out of the top, and there's no way to reload them from there since they never done that.
The Perseus also has something similar. They're designed for size 5 torpedoes, the same ones you have in the Gladiator. So I think if that's done, then they might tackle the miss they could do with that, because it's really at the moment it's a nothing vessel. But if they can get that system in, and therefore you can fill your cargo hold with torpedoes or size 5 missiles, then it'll be worth something, I think.
Mm-hmm.
Because people will see cargo hold and they either think, "Whoops, now you fell down," either fill it with ships or vehicles. Or cargo, but not ordnance. You have to put your ordnance somewhere. So don't just fill this up immediately. And I'm getting lag. And I go forward. Open. Please, let me in. So this is the main... Oh, there's
lift.
A lift.
There we... No, it's fighting again.
This is the one that goes outside. So you could possibly stop here and go straight into the torpedo room if you can gain access to that. This is the control room.
Torpedo console.
Yes. So, am I in? I am in, right. It's a super laggy. You can turn the power on.
Electromagnetic systems.
So... this is just a straightforward engineering console, nothing much. But you'll have to turn on your weapons to actually use it. I could now fire my torpedo like I did last time and screwed everything up and push my ship through the roof. But I will not, so I'm going to turn it off. You can enter a remote CCTV camera in the front.
Just a camera?
Just a camera. You can see the those sites, the big turrets there, which we'll be going into in a moment. But yeah, you actually have a CCTV camera. No, I can't get outside. I was hoping CIG would actually be bold enough to actually make that camera move on the outside as well. But oddly enough, this is where you fire your torpedoes from. So I'm guessing somebody in the front locks onto the target and then you fire it. I'm not sure how popular that will be. I suppose that's what happens in submarines. It's somebody in command who locks onto the target and then a person in the torpedo room actually fires it.
Fire!
What is cool is you do see the torpedoes being loaded into the tubes.
Oh, you see the tubes there, yeah.
We go forward again.
Well, you gotta check if it works, if it gets jammed. Like, oh crap.
Yeah, more fuses. And then this is the mother of all turrets.
The big one in the nose.
Yep. And this is where you have your pair of size 6, which are huge.
6?
They are ridiculously huge. I was hoping they'd be 7s, but... where's my power 1? No.
On the side.
Power. Power. So. Yeah. Your range is a bit limited, but like all the new turrets, it does guide you to where you can hit or can't. But you know, it's all right.
And
let's see.
You can't aim straight down.
I just don't want to.
Oh.
The front section is ballistic. These are ballistic cannons. Currently, you can't change them. I don't think there's anything to change to, though. But yeah, as you can see, you only get 300 rounds. I'm not sure what is going to happen here with replacing these. I hope CIG have a system in place that if you have ordnance in your cargo and the gunner requests change, or renew the mag, therefore it takes automatically that ordnance from the cargo bay and loads, reloads your ship. That's what makes sense.
Yeah, they need to figure out how to do that.
Yeah, I'm guessing that's what they're doing, because they're going to do something similar with crafting. That they'll, you know, crafting takes whatever is around you or in that cargo hold, so why can't they do the same for ordnance in a ship? Let's see, can I get out?
Yeah. No, not everything has to be physicalized, that somebody has to bring it to the turret. That's just...
No,
that starts becoming
a
little dumb whenever...
Yeah, it's a bit ridiculous. There's no room. There's nowhere to put it, anyway.
No, they haven't considered that, anyway.
No. So, it makes sense if they do that, you know, just to open.
You're open. Duck.
And, that's basically it. That is the Polaris.
That's basically it. It took us an hour to get through this or something.
Did it? Okay.
I don't know.
Yeah, it did. Yeah.
All right. Sorry for boring you to death. I know you've seen the other. See, look, main elevator now. That was lift.
Yeah, it was Z-fighting before. Yeah.
It's a decent ship.
It's quite impressive, I think.
It is quite impressive. It also has hit home at what is required to run this properly.
Yeah, so what, like at least 10 people or something? No, no.
Well, it's designed for 12. 6 to 12 seems to be the
six,
numbers.
Minimum.
I don't know how you can go away with 6. You're going to need at least 6 up front anyway. You're definitely going to need about possibly 2 engineers. Because all those relays, my God, there's so many relays.
Boom.
That's just going to cause a problem. Yeah, that's what they're doing right now, just ramming. Because that's all they can do, the pilots.
Yeah, I have no gun control. Yeah,
no gun control, none whatsoever.
Good.
So this is the first proper capital ship. With absolutely no control whatsoever. This is scary. This is scarily big and scarily expensive. You know, to fix all the ordnance, to refuel this. It just has millions of credits written all over it. Each time you stop off at a port to re-up your ordnance and fuel and other stock that you might need.
Bandy soft, people still use that crap? Jesus.
Oh, yeah. It's free, you see. So
that's always yes, Jesus
Christ. I know.
See, Windows has it built in even.
Got a bit of driving here.
Oh, they got the water effects on it as well.
Yeah.
He was splashed.
Yeah.
That's pretty cool.
It is pretty cool when you have the frames flying in fleets. This is cool. Fleet formations. Yeah.
But they're not moving.
Are they not moving?
I thought they were. No, he's flying through it. I don't think they're just standing still.
Yeah. Yeah, okay.
Or it would be too laggy anyway.
It would be too laggy. That's the thing. So I'm very surprised to see that. Because this is where server meshing is desperately needed in this scenario. I think the servers are holding up well at the moment because of this. Oh, they're flying now. But yeah, this is our first proper military capital ship. I look forward to seeing the attempted battles against each other. They're going to be rather lethargic at the beginning as everybody tries to figure out what is the best way of doing things. Orgs hopefully now should be properly planning and using this as a way of training, team building, and all other stuff like that. It's desperately needed. Oh, look, the door is open. Ugh, wow, okay. The ramps are open. I wish you can open the door and not the ramp.
Yeah, this is what I'm still missing from the new MFTs as well. Like all individual door control. Well, wait, that's from the engineer does that, right? The engineer has that. And that follow map thing. So why don't they put that on an MFT?
The co-pilot actually has that as well. I think somebody exploded the torpedo.
Underwater?
Maybe. It has a range, I think, of 50 meters, somebody said it once. I'm not sure if it's true or not.
I think it exploded in front of them. Boom, right there. Oops.
So, yeah. Hopefully the Perseus isn't too far behind. It's smaller and far more manageable than this beast.
Oh.
Yep, so here's the arrows. Again, they all fit nicely.
You can't move about, though.
I think you can gain access to them. And you can even squeeze them underneath, but that's a bit risky.
It's
doable. But as I said, I wouldn't recommend this because the more things you fill in the cargo hold, the less torpedoes you can carry.
You're going to be paying a shit ton of money for restocking those torps anyway.
Yeah. I'd love to know how much they actually cost in the shops. But yeah, I look forward to the realism of the cost of running this thing. Yeah, there's somebody with a helmet, I think.
Mm-hmm.
So. These are skins. I'm not sure, is CIG saying that military ships shouldn't be colorful? I don't know why. These better not be expensive. For very shades
they're
of gray,
simple, yeah.
But they're still going to charge like 26 or something. I can see it, 20 bloody euros for those. Yeah, I don't know. These are probably the only paints I won't be getting because if they are too expensive, I'm just not getting that ridiculous amount of money. The grand finale, which...
Oh, is this Foxy?
He's Torpedo War, yeah. This is an ideal tool for orgs. They need to start organizing with this, because unfortunately CIG are not providing the proper tools. And this will be the first one, really. They should be organizing team events and getting various teams to play each other or go after each other. Or if you can get a different org as well, that'd be great. But yeah, this would be excellent for orcs. For individuals who think they're going to use this as their flying home, oh, you're in for a rude awakening. It's just not going to be suitable for you. I need to disappear for a moment. Back in a second.
Innova's back. Innova was like, "Rake me up when you're done."
Is he?
I don't know. Wake up, motherfucker. No?
You guys done?
That's somewhat. And the show's over anyway. Well, no, not, yeah, not yet.
I actually went. And,
do you have anything else to say?
I went and shaved. I went and watched a whole bunch of videos and stuff.
Now, what have you learned?
I've learned that you guys wasted a whole lot of time touring a ship that is probably everybody's already seen through multiple videos.
Yeah, but we have to do it because everybody else does it.
Now, we can be unique, different, special.
Oh, look, torpedoes. Yeah, well, was there any other news?
Nobody's been talking about Star Citizen Live.
No, because I haven't watched it. What was it about?
They were talking about all the new armor, how it's all going to work, about the creatures that are in the that we're going to get to engage with. There's another monster that's even bigger than the worm.
Speaking of monsters,
all kinds of stuff.
There must be, hang on, let me just grab. The news thing. Oh, there it is. They did questions? Oh, they did questions, that's why.
Yep.
Zach Priest, Senior System Designer. Nick Beer, System Designer. Luke Presley, Senior Principal Systems Designer.
Okay, Innova, what happened since you're the only one that watches this show?
They answered a whole lot of good questions that are going to be... Well, actually, they answered a lot of questions you were interested in.
Are the extra pouches from CitizenCon 2953 still a thing?
Yes.
Not actively working on... Currently, though. Okay.
Yeah, they were actually trying to work on getting it so that you can mix and match your clothes and your armor. There's like three separate tiers of clothing and how they stack on each other. So, you know, you'll be able to do that. They've talked about not giving us parachutes, but something better. Because they were asking about parachutes.
Oh, yeah. I think they're looking at something like paragliding, I think.
Well, there was a picture that we saw a long time ago, but there was no clarification on what it was.
Parachutes? Question, yes, but not exactly a parachute. We want something that fits into a Star Citizen more. Jetpacks? Question mark. Maybe, but we have something else in mind. Wow.
I wonder, are they going to copy, you know, the new Star Trek? Do you remember the parachute scene when they did a high base jump? Down the laser, the mining laser.
You know what's interesting? They have these actual, these real live water scooters that you strap onto your legs and they propel you forward. And because they're on your legs, you can use them really well to steer because they're on your legs and they just propel you through the water.
They did the same thing with jet engines, mini jet engines.
That would function the same way in space.
But I don't think that's the direction they're going. I don't think that's the direction they're going to go. They're definitely going to come up with something like he said that we've seen that concept art of like a parasail kind of thing. But the thing you have to remember is the only reason people are asking for parachutes is because people are tired of dying from ejecting in atmosphere, because there's nothing to slow you down. You just go bump when you hit the ground and die. So it has to accommodate the very small spaces inside a ship, so that, you know, when you do eject, you can come down. I wouldn't be a bit surprised if they do something like the wings suit. I don't know if you've seen the wingsuits, where people jump out and they stretch their arms out and their legs, and they got wings in between them, and they fly around whatever.
Yeah. Yeah.
I wouldn't be a bit surprised if they maybe incorporate some of that. Who knows? Of course, you would have to have a specific suit for that. Whatever, you know. So there's that.
Specialized suits for engineering, salvage, and mining. Each designed with unique features tailored to their respective roles. The mining suit will include a dedicated visor capable of scanning and identifying materials. These suits will offer enhanced environment protection, enabling players to safely explore hazardous areas, and the salvage suit will feature a streamlined backpack that allows materials to be stored directly inside from what you salvage, optimizing storage and mobility.
Yep. Another thing that they talked about that they want to try and do is, because they were asking about being able to wear backpacks in your chairs and stuff like that.
No.
So when it comes to like drop seats for like Marines and stuff like that, they're looking at having it with an internal storage, so that what happens is it's kind of like when you sit down, it hides it in the chair. So you're just sitting there and stuff. And then when you're ready to leave, when you get up, it re-equips the arm, the backpack and your weapons on you. So that you can actually, you know, just go ahead, get up, go, and jump, or drop out of the ship, or whatever it is that you got to do. One of the other things they talked about is the suit lockers. So the suit lockers would have predefined configuration. And then what you would do is you would, you know, access the suit locker, and then what it will do is it will take the suit, put it on you with everything that you predefined it with, and then it would take whatever you were wearing and it would put it on a mannequin inside the suit locker. So it's like a one button click to swap out your clothing and suit and all that other stuff. And it would be predefined. So you don't have to worry about drag and drop, find it, drag and drop kind of thing. So they're looking for ways to make it more efficient for the player to be able to use the different types of suits and clothing and stuff like that.
Does that mean that they'll go, I guess it does, right? It does mean that they will have to go through all the suits that they already have and categorize them to a specific role, because, you know, I don't think like general suits will be a thing anymore. Like, at least
no, there will be suits or something. There will be general suits. So they did say that each item will have unique characteristics, right? Mm-hmm. Some suits are built around being a full set, right? So like the stuff that they showed us in CitizenCon, those were billed as full sets, which will reap you these extra benefits, right? But not every suit of armor is a set, or not every whatever items creates a set. So you can actually take, you know, a jacket that has certain stats that you want, and apply a different pair of pants that have a certain sets of stats that you want, and a helmet and stuff. And then so it gives you a hybrid, but it doesn't give you a set bonus per se. So you can actually come up with some pretty creative combinations yourself, not only in appearance, but in stats.
So you can be that guy, as they just demonstrated.
Exactly. You can be that guy, and for all you know, that guy has some pretty fucking cool benefits because of the stuff that he threw together.
Yeah, he's probably super stealthy and super nimble. Because he has no electronics on him or anything like that.
Yeah. They talked about one suit of armor that is like a hacker armor or techie armor, where it would generate Wi-Fi energy that could like technically charge people's energy clips if they're part of the group and they're close by. Right, some of the heavy armor could have battery chargers so they can charge the clips. So it makes more sense to be running around with an energy weapon than a ballistic weapon, because all you have to do is have it clipped onto your armor and it's going to get recharged. Right, versus having to go buy more armor or go someplace and find it or grab it or whatever. They did say they got 5 creatures planned so far, I think.
Oh, yeah, that's right. Didn't they say?
And they did say that the largest creature currently in the universe will be in Kestra.
I wonder if that's a joint.
So it's bigger. It's bigger than the worm and bigger than the whales.
Dragons.
No, the giant squid. Remember the flying squid?
Oh, that thing, yeah. Possibly. That looked pretty big. Is that in this presentation?
I think it's in there somewhere. Don't ask me where, though.
Yeah, they have, five big animals planned. I mean, they have 5 more creatures planned.
Yay.
And that they will be rolling up soon. Yeah, no, I don't think it's the Valakars that they're... The Valakars or the variants don't really apply to that. I think it's some other kind of creature. Like those things.
Yeah.
Maybe those things is what they were referring to.
I sent you the image anyway, didn't I? No.
Yeah, probably. I was running this one anyway.
They did say, and I think I mentioned it earlier in the show, that a lot of the flares and stuff like that we get, we will get blueprints for, so that we can create them ourselves. That kind of help along with replacing them if we want to, or make them better. They did say that if you try to use a MOBA or a Idris or whatever to try and kill the worm or the large creatures, you probably will destroy the resources.
And drop a bomb on it.
You will definitely destroy the resources. And so, you know, they are already anticipating players, you know, trying to cheese through the event and making sure that they have to work for it.
What's the whole square circle thing?
The projectiles that it spits out, the rocks and stuff.
Yeah.
For some reason, people are saying it's square, and Zach is saying, no, it's not square. It's conical, or it's circle. and he just wanted to get them to just shut the fuck up. You know, it's always players trying to say they know more than developers, yet the developers actually have the information in front of them.
It's probably an LOD issue, and you know.
It's people being stupid.
Yeah.
And dedicated backpacks for clothing.
Yep, you'll be able to put backpacks in clothing and stuff like that as well.
I thought we had already that.
No.
For the motorbike, for the Ranger? Remember there was a backpack?
I don't know. You know what? You're right.
Yeah, but that was...
But does it work?
No.
Does it work?
I don't know. I'd have to ask. I have one of those, actually.
But I don't know. Okay, but it's clothing. It's considered a jacket.
It's clothing.
Right now,
it's
dumb.
It's not even a backpack.
So I don't think it has
like
inventory. No. No. Well, maybe it does, because the jackets kind of have inventory nowadays as well. So maybe they tied some inventory to it, but it's considered a jacket, so it replaces whatever you're.
Well, they're good. They're
it's not supposed to be like that.
Redoing all of that stuff anyway.
Mm-hmm.
So who knows what it's going to be like.
Actually, they named the creature that's coming before the Velikar the Torluk. Or Torluk.
That sounds Jean.
It doesn't have a wiki entry at all, so I guess it's new. Yeah, Tor-Luk.
Torluk. Is that the snowy creature thingy?
I bet you. No, that's not. So actually, that's what somebody asked in the chat, and he was corrected. No, that's not the snowy creature thing. I wonder if it's going to be like Gamera.
Huh.
It's going to be a big giant turtle. It's going to be the turtle god, and then if we attack it, that we're going to piss off the Xion, and they're going to come and start the. They're going to start the war.
Yeah.
You killed our sacred turtle.
Yeah.
Now you die. Yeah, okay.
And that was it?
I don't.
I mean, it was good information. It you know, if you just go over it top level, that's basically it. Where they're definitely going to be doing a lot of things with the clothes and stuff, and there's going to be a lot of customization. They're definitely going to give us the hangar, not the hangar racks, but the armor racks and all that other kind of stuff eventually, and the functionality. No dates, wins and stuff like that, but it's cool. I'm looking forward to it.
Are you still whinging about that?
That's a really old Redeemer picture, anyway.
Redeemer, yeah. Since they changed the shields around.
Again?
People are going to bitch because nobody likes to have their favorite thing fucked with. Plus, everybody's a meta player, so if you fuck with the meta, everybody gets pissed off. Right, because now they have to figure out how to get the new meta. Right. The thing with Star Citizen is that if you finally bought the meta, and they change the meta. Now you have to sell your ship or CCU it to try and get the new meta, which means you have to spend more money.
Mm-hmm.
Good.
Good. Good.
And then they change the meta again. So like right now, everybody is trying to figure out how to get a fucking Polaris. I guarantee you, almost everybody's trying to figure out how they're going to get a Polaris. And then once they get the Polaris, they're going to be like, I can't do anything with this fucking thing.
Seriously, yeah, he's absolutely right.
It's like, I can't do shit. Except fire a couple of missiles. But there are people who are going to say, well, I don't care because it's a capital class ship. I have capital class shield.
Yeah, so
I have a hangar. I have a hangar that I can put a ship in it that I can use to move cargo or do salvage or do mining, right? Because I've seen the pictures where someone actually fit they can't fit a prospector in there, but they fit a drake in there, a vulture,
yeah,
right? And then you have where you can place vehicles, but you don't need an Ursa because you have freaking 4 medical beds.
Yeah, it's better. Yeah.
Right? So you can put something else then in there, like probably a rock or whatever. So you can do mining, ground mining. You can do salvage with the, if you take the Drake with you. You can do cargo runs and not worry about, you know, someone blowing your fucking ship up because you got capital class, you know, shields protecting you. And it should give you enough time to get into your ship. Unless, obviously, someone goes down on the ground and
shoots you or whatever. Does the pilot have control over the systems as well? Like, you can turn off and on shields?
Yeah.
From the chair?
Yeah, you got all controls.
See,
that
I think
you would normally have as a pilot.
I think they should have even limited that. So, like, the pilot by default, guns. The pilot shouldn't really have shoe control either.
No, but I can see that being changed later on.
Yeah. And then you got the point defense system, so you don't have to worry about other torpedoes being fired at you.
Yeah, they need to make that's not something else they need to flesh out with the systems. Different flight systems and how you should even be able to transfer controls to someone else's stations and stuff like that, right? Hoping. That's not
all
locked
stations,
into.
If all the stations have access to all the MFDs, well, not all the, yeah, no, actually, all the stations have access to all the MFDs.
Yeah, but you should be able to limit
for
that.
Except for the engineering ones. So I can go to any of the remote turret seats or the co-pilot seat or any of those guys, and I can bring up the MFDs and I can take control of power, I can take over control of scanning, all that shit.
See, when people take this for their mining, and when they finish everything, it's going to cost them a small fortune to refuel this ship. So I really wish people get real about
this.
Well,
the thing is, if you make the money, the
torpedoes,
it doesn't matter.
Well,
can't make that money on your own.
You got plenty of gas to get you around to do stuff without having to refuel anytime soon. So if you make enough money, you just refuel, you're good to go.
There must be more efficient ways to earn the same amount.
There is, but people are stupid.
Okay.
Anyway, I think we'll finish on that point then.
What else?
People are stupid. No, it's still 2 weeks away.
It's one and a half. The next Friday, but the Friday after that.
So we covered it, you know, quite a lot of it last week, so there's no point in going on about it.
Yeah,
just hopefully that...
Testing.
Yeah, just test 0.3 and...
4.
4.0.
Yeah, 0.3 and 4.0. 4.0 is getting closer to stable. They were supposed to put missions in or something this last patch. I only saw one mission and I wasn't able to complete it. And I don't know if it was because the way I tried to complete it, I didn't get close enough first for it to be triggered that I was there. So basically I had a mission to blow up some tanks. At an outpost, and I just took the A2 and just flew by and dropped the bombs and not only blew up the tanks but blew up everything that was there. But I didn't get credit for completing the mission. And again, I don't know if it was because it didn't register that I had gotten there before I hit it with the bombs or whatever. But it looks like they are trying to move forward. The jump points are a little bit more stable, but they're not fully there yet. So still got a few more of those to go through before I think they're ready to introduce more stuff into 4.0.
Sorry to go back in here. So Mighty's brought up an interesting issue that's popped up about the Polaris. He's also provided a link. So remember I said about the point defense turrets only going after missiles and torpedoes, and they really should be able to go after ships as well. And this
they shouldn't be able to. That's not what a point defense system is for.
No, that's this is
a point defense system is for shooting missiles and rockets out of the sky. That is what it's for. It is not to be firing at ships.
So what about
that's what your turrets are for. That's what your crew is for.
So what about kamikaze ships?
That is what your turrets are for. That is what your crew is for. A point defense system is like the phalanx on the U.S. ships.
No, I know what it is.
And what they do is they target onto cruise missiles that are coming at them at supersonic speed and blow them out of the sky before they hit you.
But that is real life. This is a game, so therefore people can kamikaze.
No, that's the problem. People think because it's a game that they should be able to do everything and everything should be able to protect them so nothing can happen to them. No. I disagree.
Someone in the ship is basically a missile if he intends to ram you.
Well, you know, that it was a legitimate tactic back in World War II. And you had the turret gunners trying to shoot those guys out of the sky before they actually hit the ship. Which is what the turrets are for.
Jeez.
Alright, okay, alright.
You really hate single player ships, don't you?
Who, me?
Yeah.
No. I don't like cheese. I mean, I've played enough games where I was a god and I could do whatever the fuck I want. And I just got tired of the game really fast. You know, I mean, I know that's what games are for. Games are to be entertaining, to make you feel like you are, you know, well, you are the protagonist, right? You are supposed to be the badass and all that other stuff. But the shit gets, you know, to be kind of boring after a while when you can just walk around and just kill anything without even trying. Now, don't get me wrong. I'm terrified of playing Star Citizen by myself because I know that my skills are not the best and I'm going to have to deal with people that are assholes as well as people that are playing unlawful characters, right? And I have to be able to deal with it.
The game has to be released already to get one of you fuckers to say, hey, come over and hang out.
So it's like
inviting people. Who do you think you were?
You know, so it's one of those things. It's like, you know, I'm either going to have to deal with it or I'm going to have to find a solution kind of thing. Right.
I be sociable.
Yeah, no.
we really have to get over that hump someday.
Yeah.
Today. Most of those types will stab you in the back. You don't know
them,
so they're just gonna.
Yeah. It takes a while to actually trust somebody. Oh, don't worry. We'll play with each other one day. But not today.
Billy messed up my ship. Okay. I guess that's it.
Hopefully next week we'll have a couple of new videos that we can talk about. I don't know what they're going to be doing.
Well, at least it'd be a proper IFC, you know.
Yeah. Maybe. So.
Hopefully they'll probably start previewing the new ships. Maybe.
IE content then.
Yeah.
Okay. Nice. All right then. Thank you all for being here and. Till next week.
Yeah. Okay.
Bye-bye.
Get out there and test.
Enjoy the life, guys.
I support the monkeys. Do you? Check out the base.
With the leg.
24/7 online radio. Visit us at thebase.sc. They're professional.
Oh, 9 o'clock.